unfold. The dream front row, Marquez, Rossi and Lorenzo. Pedrosa, Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone on row two.
Row three, Maverick Vinales, Hector Barbera, what a performance by him, and Cal Crutchlow. Round four, Paul Espargaro, Aleix Espargaro and Bradley Smith.
Lois Baz, a career best 13th place for him, ahead of Scott Redding and Jack Miller on row five. Bradl, Laverty and Michele Pirro standing in for Danilo Petrucci on row six.
And row seven, Tito Rabat, race winner in Moto2, Batista and Yoni Hernandez, the local man. 21 riders do battle in a flag-to-flag race to decide the outcome of the Grand Prix of the Republic of Argentina. The man in pole position, Marc Márquez, who won the race here 2 years ago, crashed out last year after a collision with Valentino Rossi. The final sighting lap. Let's let them get away and just have one last word with Dylan about the conditions. I think we're there now, Dylan. What do you think?
Well, it's dry at the moment. I'd rather not have to predict too far in the future. You know what, we do have dark clouds, but they have been hovering around for quite some time. So do you know what, fingers crossed it won't rain. But even if it does, the teams will be prepared. As you can imagine, the atmosphere not just is, quite tense, shall we say. The mechanics are going to have to be on their A game. The number two bikes are already fired up just in case there's any mistake with the bike on this warm-up lap. And afterwards, they'll have to be ready for that flag-to-flag.
Right with Jorge Lorenzo, the clear visor, of course. This is down this long back straight, over 1,000 meters long, over half a mile long into turn five. Certainly the track we've seen, and you've commentated on Moto3 and Moto2, looks drier than it has been throughout the afternoon so far. It's not how the track is now, it's just how it's going to be. 25 degrees centigrade, it was well over 10 degrees, even more than that, warmer on Friday. 29 degrees centigrade, the track temperature. Little bit of a breeze about. Does that keep the clouds away or does that blow them in? We are about to find out as we ride with Andrea Dovizioso.
Yeah, you're going into this race with a different mentality, a different mindset, knowing already you've got to stop for a flag-to-flag. It's a very unusual scenario for these riders. Laps 9, 10 and 11, they're the ones to keep an eye on. You've got to come in, as you can see on that caption at the bottom of your screen. The race has been declared dry. It's a 20-lap race. They've all got to come in and swap bikes at the end of laps 9, 10 or 11. Just to quickly remind you, if it does start raining, then race direction will throw the red flag. If it's considered to be too dangerous, and all the riders will enter the pit lane, then there will be a restart. We'll come to that, though, if that eventuality is required, because the riders coming to the grid for what is about to be a really dramatic, nail-biting 20 laps.
Yeah, it's not like a Misano situation where the riders have to make a decision. The only decision they have to make is when they come in. Do the teams decide that? Do the riders decide that? Scott Redding didn't give too much away, really, did he? So here we go, round two, the MotoGP World Championship here in Argentina. It's flag to flag and they are away.
Oh, Valentino Rossi had a wheelie offline, then he got a rear tyre spinning. Rossi's getting swamped on the run down to the first corner. Lorenzo's got the whole shot. Iannone almost tags the back of Marc Márquez. Iannone runs one, he runs Dani Pedrosa out two into the marbles at the first corner. Lorenzo leads from Marc Márquez. Valentino Rossi trying to pick up ground. Maverick Vinales got a good start. He's already up to fourth place.
Well, I was a lucky man, Andrea Iannone. Definitely touched the back of Dani Pedrosa and pushed him very, very wide indeed. Andrea Dovizioso. We ride with Jorge Lorenzo. They come onto the back straight for the first time. Who's got the grunt? Who's got the power? Who's brave under the brakes into turn five? We're about to find out.
It's the Ducati power that's enabled Andrea, you know. Andrea Dovizioso, Rod, hit the front. Valentino Rossi got a real poor launch off the line. He got a wheelie, and then as the rear tyre dug in, it spun up off the grid on the dirty part of the track, and Rossi has done brilliantly to come back into second place already ahead of his teammate Jorge Lorenzo. Dovizioso leads on the Ducati. Andrea Iannone's back down in eighth place after that very early tangle with Dani Pedrosa.
Down at turn seven and eight, Dovizioso still leads the way. Dani Pedrosa tries to fight back, but Rossi closes up on Dovizioso. There's Marc Márquez. Look at Vinales up the inside now of Jorge Lorenzo. That little dip, turn nine. Now down towards turn 10. And the fast left-hander at 11.
Lorenzo's being really super cautious. He got the whole shot down into the first corner, but he's being swallowed up on this opening lap. Lorenzo now back down into fifth place and under real pressure from the fast-starting Hector Barbera.
We ride with Valentino Rossi through turn 13. momentarily upright, then tip it into 14. Second place, Dovizioso crosses the line in the lead. Rossi right behind him, Marquez. They've opened that tree up, just opened up a little bit of a gap. Rossi sniffs up the inside of Dovizioso and thinks, no, Marquez closes up on Rossi.
Who's right on Valentino Rossi's back wheel? It's none other than Marquez. Here we go, we're on board with the Spaniard through turn number two. He's chasing the Italians, Andrea Dovizioso and Valentino Rossi. Lorenzo came over the line in fifth place. He's still in that sixth place under real pressure, though, from Hector Barber. Valentino Rossi won't be able to slipstream that Ducati down the back straight. Look at the legs that the Ducati's got on that Yamaha. Pulls about five or six bike lengths. No way for Rossi to attack down in turn five. Cal Crutchlow and Aleix Espargaró have crashed out. It's come up on our monitors here. Crutchlow and Espargaró crashed out of the race.
Well, not even a 1.5 laps gone. We're in 1.5 laps. Now Jorge Lorenzo is coming under pressure from Hector Barber. He made the hole shot. He is struggling. Rossi closes up on Dovizioso once again. Marquez seemingly looked quite happy to watch just from behind. Well, this is familiar territory, isn't it? Rossi and Dovizioso going at each other like this.
Aleix Espargaró and Cal Crutchlow have rejoined the race, but the man is really struggling. It's Jorge Lorenzo. Got a good launch off the line, but he just can't run the pace at the moment. Is he being overcautious? The reigning world champion is Marc Marquez. Lines up Valentino Rossi down to turn number 13. Rossi's the master of the late breaking move. No way through for Marc Marquez. Rossi closes up on Andrea Dovizioso. Marquez, what an onboard shot that is from Rossi as they flick it left through turn number 14. Over the line, Dovizioso leads Rossi from Marquez.
Up the start and finish straight. This is where Marquez crashed at the end of qualifying yesterday. We ride with Valentino Rossi. Once again, Marquez closes up on him. Round turn two, up towards the left-hander at turn three. Vinales is absolutely flying at the moment in fourth place with Iannone behind him.
It's getting pretty tight between Marquez and Valentino Rossi. Jack Miller's a man on the charge. Jack Miller is up to seventh place. He got ahead of Hector Barber on that previous lap. He's now hunting down Jorge Lorenzo, the Australian. Yamaha just hasn't got the legs of the Ducati. Can Rossi get in the slipstream and get close enough to move out and make a brave move down at turn number five? He thought about it. No, Dovizioso is so good late on the brakes.
Rossi did think about it, but Dovizioso strong on the brakes. Don't forget, if you just tuned in, if you've forgotten, I have, because I'm so excited what's happening in the front. This is a flag-to-flag race. They have to come in at the end of neither 9, 10 or 11. And while they fight it out at the front here, the two behind are closing up on them to make it a fivesome.
Johnny Hernandez has crashed out of the race. Was Jack Miller moving through on Jorge Lorenzo at the back of our picture there? Marc Marquez then up the inside of Valentino Rossi. Beautiful move up at turn number 9. He holds it through turn number 10. Marquez then up in a second place. Next in his sights is Andrea Dovizioso. Marquez closes right up on the rear of that Ducati. Can he make a move down into turn number 13?
He's thinking about it at 13, as you say, Dovizioso. Late on the brakes, here comes Marquez up the inside. The Honda leads the way. Does he run it wide? No. Pulls back across the track into 14. Three great laps gone, and Marquez now leads the way.
Marquez, what a third lap from the Spaniard. Picked off Rossi up at turn number 9, and three corners later, disposed of Andrea Dovizioso. The fastest man on track is the man in fifth place, Andrea Iannone, who was caught up in a bit of a tangle down at the first corner. Rossi under pressure now from Maverick Vinales. Jack Miller, we just saw at the top of your picture, has picked off Jorge Lorenzo. Brilliant from the Marc VDS rider. Miller up into sixth place. Lorenzo still struggling.
Onto the back straight they come. So Marquez leads, Dovizioso, Rossi, there is Vinales.
Miller's gone down, sorry, I think Jack Miller crashed out at the top of the picture. I'm pretty sure we've just lost Jack Miller out of sixth place. He just made a move on Lorenzo. Andrea Dovizioso's blitzed back past Marc Marquez. Marquez has got the inside line at turn number 5. Is the door open for Rossi as well to sweep up on the inside? Rossi cuts it back around the outside of Dovizioso. Frantic action at the front in Argentina.
Marquez leads and Rossi just holds onto that second place as they come down now towards turn 7 and 8.
Unfortunately, we did lose Jack Miller. He was in a fight for sixth place with Jorge Lorenzo. He's gone down at turn number 3. That leaves Jorge Lorenzo in a pretty lonely sixth place at the moment. Andrea Dovizioso went from first to third in the matter of a couple of seconds. Here is Miller.
there. We're going to watch it now, yeah. Just coming through turn three, coming onto that back straight. Oh, a lot of damage to the Mark VDS Honda. What do you do here, Dylan? 9, 10 or 11 in this sort of situation? Do you try to come in early? Do you wait? It's very important when they do come in.
No, I think do come in early. I mean, Marcus is pit boy. They're telling him L5, so it looks like he'll be coming in right in the middle. Looks like he'll be coming in on lap number 10 with Tito Rabat. They have L4, for instance, so it looks like he'll be in straight away on lap number 9. Do you know what? If you can try and get equal laps on both tyres, that's where you can ultimately get the maximum out of it, so you can argue that coming in on lap number 10 would probably be your best bet.
Coming into turn two, Marquez leads the way. Now you're only beginning to put a bit of pressure, as he did in Qatar, on his teammate Andrea Dovizioso. That pressure didn't last because he crashed out of the race. Boy, what is it like down in pit lane, Dylan? They must be frantically waiting.
Well, and that's kind of what it is. I mean, it's so quiet here because, you know, they're just counting down. The bikes are all completely ready. But, you know, I tell you, once it's another 2-3 laps, that's when you have the mechanics there, because obviously they need to time warming the bike up, getting the tyre warmers off. It'll be a very tense time in a few laps.
Let's just Spargo back in the race.
Yeah, you can see he's got some crash damage there on the inside. What happened here? Cal Crutchlow, well, Alexis Spargo's gone really, really wide. That was like a tandem front end loss. They separate instance between Cal Crutchlow and Andrea Dovizioso. And who can win the 100 metre sprint to pick up their bikes?
Good job they got on the right bikes, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Cal Crutchlow signs for Suzuki there. I think he was going to jump on the wrong bike. Both okay, but both missed out the chance. There is chance for points there, isn't there? That's the most important thing. Marquez is piling on the pressure at the front. Marquez knows if he can build up a good advantage and get in there and change bikes as quick as he can. And you know, only having problems getting past Dovizioso, but he's through.
Beautiful move by Iannone. Dovizioso though cuts it back at the inside of turn number 13. Great fight between the two Factory Ducati men. Mar Marquez, he knew he wanted to get to the front of this field. He wants to be the first man into the pit lane. He don't want to be getting caught up with anybody else in those bike swaps. Maverick Vinales has run wide at the first corner. We just saw his teammate Aleix Espargaró. Aleix Espargaró just running way too hot. He got onto the wide part of the circuit. On the dirty part, Lorenzo's down. Jorge Lorenzo, the reigning world champion, has crashed out of the first corner. He was having a nightmare. It's just got worse.
Lorenzo crashes out, and it looks like it is the end of the race for the world champion and the race winner in Qatar 2 weeks ago. It's over for Jorge Lorenzo. He walks away. No points for the world champion and the championship leader.
Just didn't get going at all, Nick, in that race. Yeah, losing the front through very late in the corner through that turn number one. What a disaster for Lorenzo. He just didn't get going. He was running, what, 6/10 of a second a lap off of the lead group.
Well, they're on their 7th lap at the moment. Let's ride with Lorenzo. Yeah, we've seen many a man go down there this weekend, but that's the biggest mistake of them all, isn't it?
Was he a fraction offline, just onto a dirty part of the track? You know, did he just clip? There are still the odd damp patches scattered around this circuit. We saw Alex Marquez and Franco Morbidelli have problems there in the Moto2 race. Maybe he just clipped a damp patch, but Lorenzo is out of the race. He didn't even make it to the 9th, 10th or 11th lap to swap bikes.
Tell you what, the front, as a Dovizioso and Iannone, it's making good entertainment. It's great to watch, but what they're doing, they're letting Rossi and Marquez just clear off at the front. But Rossi is not letting Marquez get away.
Yeah, Marquez is just able to eke out a 10th of a second every lap. 1:48 on the last lap. Rossi was a 1:40.9. So we've had plenty of drama already so far. We've had crashes for Cal Crutchlow and Aleix Espargaró. They're both back in the race. But the big news, the world champion Jorge Lorenzo, who was struggling down in sixth place, has crashed out at the first corner. What, we're on lap number 7, so we've got 2 more laps before you are eligible to come into the pits.
We ride with Marc Marquez onto the back straight. That is the gap. Visually you can see between him and Valentino Rossi, first and second. Reminds us of last year when the gap was bigger than that and Rossi closed him down and got past him. And then, of course, there was the collision as they go through turn five. They must be getting ready now, Dylan, in pit lane.
Not yet. I mean, you've got one mechanic with each Repsol Honda bike, but you know what? This is an extremely fast process. The bikes are all ready. All they need to do is tyre warmers off, fire them up, and then they're good to go. They'll be doing that exactly on the lap when they're about to come in.
Is there something loose hanging off the back of Marc Marquez's Repsol Honda? I'm pretty sure from that aerial shot we saw something hanging off the back of Marc Marquez. Look at this, this was the start for Rossi. Got a shocker. Wheelie off the line, and then when the rear tyre grips, massive wheel spinning. Watch Andrea Iannone on the number 29, the far left-hand side of his screen. Oh, Andrea Iannone was in way too hot. You could see him stamping all over the rear brake. The rear was hopping up, caught Dani Pedrosa. The luckless Dani Pedrosa, absolutely nothing he could do. Pushed him out onto the slippery part of the track. Yeah. On board with Marquez,
who made a decent start, but Lorenzo made a fabulous start, as you can see. Dani Pedrosa actually made a good start, didn't he, from the second row?
Marc Marquez was really, really lucky then, because Andrea Iannone got in just way, way too hot on the inside. Couldn't stop that Ducati. Clearly made contact with the back of Marc Marquez, and as he ran wide, he took Pedrosa out wide. Well, I'm not sure, actually, if that impact might have actually knocked Marc Marquez's onboard, rear-facing onboard camera loose. That might be what's dangling down. That's probably from... It is. I'm sure that's probably from that early contact with Andrea Iannone.
Deja vu. Remember, 12 months ago, it was very, very much like this. The difference here today is it's got to be flag to flag. Rossi really closes up on Marquez. The two Ducatis still hold off the Suzuki of Vinales. Decision time is coming up. They've got to start thinking about when they're going to come in. Oh, without a doubt, you can see it as clear as daylight now. I think it is the onboard camera that's come off, and it was with the collision. It appeared that it was the collision with Andrea Iannone. Spot on, Matt.
It took fair old whack on the seat unit from Andrea Iannone, didn't he, Marc Marquez? Lucky, actually, to stay on.
Sorry, guys, just to butt in. So we now have the factory Ducati mechanics out in pit lane ready, and both the Repsol Honda team guys as well. The Suzuki guys have come out as well, and Aprilia is also starting to move.
What will be interesting to see, well obviously, it won't matter because the camera will. But Marc, as you would imagine, going to come in as soon as he can. He must know, but perhaps he doesn't know there's something wrong.
Well, yeah, but I don't think that's going to affect his speed in any kind of way. Do you know what I mean? He's not going to feel that onboard camera moving around. You know, it's, you know, as long as the actual rear seat unit isn't broken, then it shouldn't be a problem.
There's nothing between those two at the front. Maverick Viñales has worked his way up into third place. He took both of the factory Ducatis on that previous lap. There's nothing between Rossi and Marc Marquez. Rossi's just put in the best lap of the race, a 140.6. The good thing is, for Marc Marquez, if there are any problems with that onboard camera, he's got to come in, of course, and change bikes. So
that's absolutely right. I think they're coming in race direction. They can now pit. Swapping bikes is mandatory.
Marquez now has box written on his pit board.
Yeah, Marc Marquez, he got it all squirrely coming out of turn number three. The rear was hopping around all over the track. Big wheel spin from Marquez, and that's all Valentino Rossi needed. Rossi sweeps up the inside of Marc Marquez. Marquez, though, cuts it back brilliantly. Rossi was in a fraction too hot. This is what we wanted, the showdown in Argentina again between Marc Marquez and Valentino Rossi.
Is there going to be a showdown in pit lane? Are they going to come in together for the flag-to-flag race just to add that little bit more drama? Here we go. Here, Marquez on the replay. Does Rossi? Yes, he does. Runs it a fair bit wide going into turn five, and he's back in front.
Yeah. And Rossi's mechanics are now taking the tyre warmers off, and Marquez's mechanics ready as well, so it looks like they'll come in tandem.
It could not be closer. This is absolutely magnificent motorcycle racing. Valentino Rossi in second place. Marc Marquez leads the way. A mandatory flag-to-flag race. It does appear both of them will be coming in.
Oh, they've gone round. No. They've gone round again, so they'll probably be coming in. They're saying now, Marc Marquez, clearly you can see their box. So they'll go round for this lap. Will the two leaders, Maverick Viñales and Andrea Iannone, then the first two in. Viñales on the Suzuki, the pit lane's open, and Viñales and Andrea Iannone have come in.
So the Suzuki and the Ducati are in. Flag to flag, hand goes up. Viñales swaps pretty quick. Vizioso, you imagine, would be the same. Looks like Dani Pedrosa has come in as well.
Yeah, Eugene Laverty has, so has Loris Baz, Hector Barbera, Stefan Bradl. There you can see the two of Vinci Ducatis heading back out onto the track.
An absolutely fantastic swap over from Viñales. He really gained quite a few metres on Iannone in there.
Rossi closes right up on Marquez once again.
This is like a carbon copy of last year.
It's deja vu, isn't it? It really is. Rossi right behind Marquez. Does he want to just get past him on the brakes? And Rossi leads the way. And they're both going to come into the pits together. And now Marquez retakes the lead.
This is all about not track position, but pit position for the pit lane. They want to be the first one in because then you'll have the advantage coming out. It's a real shame that Andrea Iannone damaged that rear-facing onboard camera of Marc Marquez, because we've been getting some absolutely brilliant shots now of Valentino Rossi. They're going to come in this time. We saw on both their pit boards, clear communication box. So they are going to be coming in. They come down now to turn number 13. Marquez has got the advantage then coming into the pits. Here they come, the two leaders, Rossi and Marquez together.
Here they come, Dylan. Oh, he looks one way and Rossi's the other way. Engine limiters on, 93 and 46. They're at it once again. They're both in to swap machines. A mandatory flag to flag here in Argentina.
Rossi's got it nailed. He's out on that factory Yamaha. Marquez, no surprise. The first thing he does is have a glance over his right shoulder to see where Valentino Rossi is. There's Andrea Dovizioso as well on the number four Ducati. So this is it now. Marquez and Rossi head back out onto the track.
And guys, just a quick word to sort of point out with the flag to flags, can be quite dangerous. One of Bautista's mechanics got a little bit of a knock when he came in. He looks okay though, got a few medics attending to him, nothing too serious, but it just shows how tricky these conditions can be.
I tell you what, that was it's Tito Rabat holding up Valentino Rossi there, not deliberately of course, but Marquez actually got out in front of him, didn't he, into turn one, and he's going to get that throttle open now, and Rossi's got to get past him.
Yeah, and Valentino Rossi, he ran a little bit wide into that turn number two as well. You know, just, you've got to remember that they've had tyre warmers on these bikes, but the tyres won't be up to temperature, the brakes as well. Valentino Rossi looked like he just ran in a little bit too hot there because he hasn't got the temperature yet in those carbon brakes. So, yeah, that could be. Was that the deciding moment of this race?
So they come in together. There was certainly no difference in the advantage when they came in and when they went out, but it's actually when they got back on the track, wasn't it?
That was an absolutely dream, perfect bike swap by Marc Marquez. And then with Valentino Rossi just perhaps not getting a confidence in that front end on that new tyre, not up to temperature just yet, and Marc Marquez, well, he's already gapping Valentino Rossi in a big, big way.
9.5 laps to go, round two of the MotoGP World Championship. Mandatory flag to flag. We go through the other riders in the field just when I think things have settled down after the flag to flag bit. It's pretty simple to see what's happening at the front. Marquez leads the way from Rossi, and Rossi, I think Matt is dead right, just a little bit cautious at the moment, and Marquez has really got the hammer down. Can he open up too big an advantage for Valentino Rossi?
It's been an absolute nightmare for Rossi, Nick, because they came into the pits side by side. Rossi now is 2.7 seconds behind Marc Marquez. It could already be race over. The difference in lap times, Marquez on his first flying lap on his second bike, put in a 2:03.134. Valentino Rossi did a 2:05.750.
Here is Marc Marquez, race winner here a couple of years ago, third in that opening round of the championship in Qatar. And looks in extremely good nick at the moment as he comes down towards turn five. Look at that gap. He is just opening it out every metre of this circuit.
Yeah, it's up to over 3 seconds. Marc Marquez. Look at those black scuff marks on his leathers. I would imagine that that's probably from the impact made by Andrea Iannone's Ducati very early on in the race. But Marc Marquez at the moment with 9 laps to go, he's got this race under complete control now. He's coming under real intense pressure from that man there, Valentino Rossi. But you know, was Rossi, as he came out of the pit lane, just momentarily distracted by Tito Rabat, who was on the inside?
I think
Rossi
he was.
Couldn't cut back to the line because Rabat was there. And then Rossi just didn't have any temperature in his front brake and no temperature in the front tyre. No such problems for Marc Marquez. He's just pulling away at the front now. 3.5 seconds is the advantage over Rossi.
Right, let's have a look a bit further down. Vinales in third place. As Marquez crosses the line, there are 8 laps to go. Rossi, we see him across the line. Vinales, Dovizioso, Iannone. It was Tito Rabat, it won't be now because he's just pulled in the previous lap. So there's a fair old gap now. Next through probably will be Dani Pedrosa. There is Danny Pedrosa, yeah, crosses the line. Scott Redding going well in seventh place. Hector Barbera, eighth. Paul Espargaro, ninth. Eugene Lafferty, that would be his best ever MotoGP result in 10th. 11th, it's Stefan Bradl going well on the Aprilia. Then we have a Tito Rabat. Bradley Smith having a really, really tough time at the moment in 13th place. Loris Baz and Cal Crutchlow, despite the crash, completing the point scoring.
Yeah, you have to feel sorry for Danny Pedrosa because he was the innocent victim of a bit of a pushing and shoving down the first corner. Look at that, Ducati GP15 of Scott Redding. This will be a good experience for Redding, dicing with Danny Pedrosa, and Redding makes a move, used the slipstream of the Ducati. Well, he didn't really need a slipstream, to be fair. That Ducati is so quick. So Scott Redding there now, up inside the top six.
Yeah, everything that happened to Scott Redding yesterday and all the problems afterwards with the discussions about tyres. This is a tremendous ride by Scott Redding.
Yeah, just quickly going back to that lead duo. Marc Marquez now is 4.3 seconds clear of Valentino Rossi. Not even Rossi is going to claw that back with just eight laps to go. Scott Redding's already stretched a bit of an advantage over Danny Pedrosa. Marquez over the line then. The gap now 4.8 seconds. He's 1.1 seconds a lap faster than Valentino Rossi. And Valentino Rossi actually will be doing pretty well at the moment to keep these three at bay, because Maverick Viñales is only 1.6 seconds behind him, and Viñales on the last lap was half a second quicker.
Viñales chasing his first ever podium finish in MotoGP, and the 21-year-old having a great ride. Danny Pedrosa tries to close up on Scott Redding. Scott Redding in sixth place. Hector Barbera in eighth, ninth. Paul Espargaro, 10th, Eugene Lafferty, and 11th, Stefan Bradl, then Tito Rabat. There is six and a half laps to go for Marc Marquez, and a little bit more for some of the others. Bradley Smith, Cal Crutchlow has moved in front of Alvaro, but in fact in front of Loris Baz, who himself now has pulled in for his mandatory flag-to-flag. Yeah, he did brilliantly when he came out of pit lane, didn't he, Marc Marquez? He just got in front of Tito Rabat.
But just look at the lap time difference since they returned to the track. Lap 11, Marquez was 2.6 seconds faster. Lap 12, a second faster. He's just been taking huge, huge chunks out of Valentino Rossi. At the moment, it looks like it'll be sweet, sweet revenge for Marc Marquez in Argentina. Maverick Viñales still holding that third place. He's going to come under severe pressure, though, from the two factory Ducatis behind him. Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone were half a second faster than Viñales on the last lap.
Here is Marquez coming to turn 14, that familiar number 93. That is six laps to go for the race winner here a couple of years ago. Up towards turn one, where he went down in a big heap in qualifying yesterday, but it was still started the race in pole position. Yeah, Rossi 6 seconds down now.
Valentino Rossi struggling here, Nick. 1.2 seconds slower than Marquez on that last lap, and now the gap to Maverick Viñales in third is down to under a second. There we go. There's Rossi coming up to turn two, and the Viñales, Dovizioso and Iannone hunting the nine times world champion down.
Yeah, five and a half laps to go. Rossi running second. We're going to find himself way, way off the podium if this progress continues. There is Rossi as they come onto the back straight. Dovizioso, Iannone behind him. We know how fast those Ducatis are down here, down towards turn five. And there looks like there's some pretty major problems for the race winner here last year as they break into turn five. Five and a half laps to go, round two of the World Championship. Scott Redding running in sixth. Danny Pedrosa behind him in seventh place.
Rossi's just had no pace at all since the bike swap. He's just doing mid-141s. Marc Marquez comfortably in the low 140s. Hector Barbera having a fight with Paul Espargaro. There's Eugene Lafferty. This will be by far his best MotoGP result. Currently running in 10th place, holding off the German Stefan Bradl on the factory Aprilia. What about that gap? Rossi to Viñales, Nick, now is just a tenth of a second. Valentino Rossi is under real, real pressure. The nine times world champion is really, really struggling out there at the moment. Viñales is going to attack down at this turn number 13. Can he get close enough
This is worrying times for Valentino Rossi. He might even be pushed off the podium.
I tell you, it's not a question of if, it's a question of when, absolutely. Isn't it? Vinales is going to take him. There's obviously some major problems with the second machine since the swap over, since the mandatory flag to flag for Valentino Rossi. Into turn one they come. The two Ducatis, they've been at each other's throats throughout the race so far. Just under five laps to go. Rossi still running in second place. Vinales, first ever MotoGP podium. The two Ducatis still slogging out behind him. Rossi's trying all he can to fight off at Vinales.
Maverick Vinales is performing heroics on that Suzuki. Look at it, he's tying itself in knots. That's how hard he's pushing coming out of turn number three. The Ducatis behind him will close up in the slipstream. The Ducatis got brutal horsepower down that back straight. Now this is turning out to be a real thrilling fight. At fourth, second place, all problems for Scott Redding on the Pramac Ducati.
Yeah, mechanical problems, obviously. Looks like his race is over. That's cruel luck for Scott Redding, who is running an absolutely brilliant sixth place and fighting off the challenge of Danny Pedrosa.
He was pulling chunks of time out of Danny Pedrosa. He'd almost moved 1 second clear of the Spaniard. That's really, really cruel. It's been a horrible weekend for Scott Redding. You can just see gutted, frustrated. That's really difficult to take on the chin after all he's gone through this weekend so far.
Valentino Rossi is not going to make life easy for these boys behind him, is he? He's trying all he can to keep Vinales, Dovizioso and Iannone at bay. Here is Vinales running in third place. I don't think he'll want to take too many risks because he wants to finish on the podium. But if he doesn't keep the pace right up, the Ducatis are going to suck him in and pass him, aren't they?
Yeah, Rossi's definitely responded because for the first time in a few laps, he's back in the 140s. So he's got the message. He knows there's a bit of a freight train building up behind him. Rossi's struggling with the front end of that Yamaha. That's been his problem since the restart. He had a big moment there coming through the first corner, Valentino Rossi. It's all with the front end. He's out a little bit wide again through turn number two. That's allowed Vinales to close up again. Rossi's just had no front end confidence since the restart.
Well, they're very, very close indeed as they come onto the back straight, down towards turn five. Can he be close enough? Here comes Maverick Vinales, side by side on the brakes. Rossi won't let him through. Vinales on the Suzuki, still trying to get up the inside. Rossi just holds the advantage.
Yeah, Valentino Rossi's gone from thinking he might win this Argentinian Grand Prix now to fighting tooth and nail just to cling on to a podium place. Andrea Dovizioso's just being dropped off this battle for second. Don't write off Andrea Iannone. He's an aggressive attacking rider. He'll fancy his chance of closing down on Valentino Rossi. You have to say he's doing a brilliant job so far of defending that second place. We finally see the sun beating through the clouds here in Argentina. Sun shining on Marc Marquez, no doubt about that. He's 7 seconds clear of this battle.
Yeah, this is the battle for second place. We thought it was only a matter of time, but Vinales got past Rossi, but somehow Rossi is hanging on. And Vinales, in turn, is now coming under real pressure from the Ducati of Andrea Iannone into turn 12. Marc Marquez crosses the line. 3 laps to go in this 20-lap race as he tips it into turn one. What is happening behind?
All Andrea Iannone's got to do now is get tucked right in behind Maverick Vinales' Suzuki. Oh, Maverick Vinales loses the front at the first corner. Disaster for Vinales. He was heading for his first MotoGP podium. It's all gone wrong. Hands in heads for the Suzuki team.
Right, Rossi second, Iannone third. Iannone, I'm sure, will have a go at his friend Valentino Rossi. Here we go.
Oh, he got onto the damp part of the track, didn't he?
Just saw that little damp bit there, didn't you? And he was coming under pressure from Iannone.
He would have still been trailing the front brake there, Maverick Vinales. You can see he was in a little bit wider than Iannone. Yeah, you can just see that darker piece of tarmac, still damp from the rain. Poor old Maverick Vinales down with his first MotoGP World Championship podium within touching distance. That's given Valentino Rossi a bit of breathing space for the podium because Andrea Dovizioso doesn't look like he's going to be able to claw that gap back. Although, to be fair to Rossi, having realised how much Vinales is putting the pressure on him, he really did respond.
Yeah, he certainly did. Here is the potential race winner, Marc Marquez. Be the third year we've been here, we've won two of them. This is the race winner from last year, running in second place. It's been a good ride by Valentino Rossi, challenging for the lead until they swap bikes, the mandatory flag to flag. and problems after that. Nannone is closing up on him all the time. Even Dovizioso might think, well, we're going to have two laps to go. I might fancy to try and have a go here, but they've got to get past Rossi, and that's not going to be easy. But don't forget that Suzuki has got the brute power. And in some ways, it was the presence of Iannone that caused Vinales to crash, wasn't it?
Yeah, Andrea Iannone, if you can tag on to the back wheel of Valentino Rossi coming out of turn number three, then if it's a horsepower shootout to turn number five, then there's only one winner. That will be Andrea Iannone's Ducati, but Rossi defending brilliantly. Despite those front-end issues, he's out way, way wide again, though, Rossi. He looked so strong, didn't he, in the first half of the race?
He looked a potential race winner,
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, he really did. And now he's fighting to stay on the podium. Rossi on the Yamaha, the two Ducatis trying to hunt him down. And hunt him down, they come down towards turn five. 1.5 laps to go. Here comes Iannone, and I don't think there's anything Valentino Rossi can do. Oh, and Dovizioso has sneaked through on the two of them. Unbelievable move by Andrea Dovizioso.
Yeah, Iannone got him too hot on the brakes at turn number five. Ran a little bit wide. It forced Valentino Rossi to pick up. Andrea Dovizioso just sat at the back of it and said, thank you very much, I'm coming through. Rossi fights back on Andrea Iannone. These two had a great scrap for the final podium place in Australia in Phillip Island last October, but Andrea Dovizioso, Christmas came early for him there. What a present.
And what a bit of canny old riding. Went old head, great on the brake, saw the opportunity, and now he's got the hammer down. So it could be his second successive second place this season, and also here in Argentina. What can Valentino Rossi do? Can he claw back that third place? Don't think there's any doubt about who's going to win the race. One lap to go for Marc Márquez here in the Argentinian sunshine.
Yeah, Rossi with it all to do now, just to get back on the podium. Remembering the first part of the race, it looked like he might actually go on and win it for the second year in a row here at the Turnmaster Rio Hondo. Andrea Dovizioso has got about half a second on his teammate Andrea Iannone. So there's real pressure on Valentino Rossi now just to salvage a podium place.
They come through turn two, into three, then four. The right-hander that brings them onto the back straight. Just about half a lap to go here in Argentina. This is where Dovizioso, at the end of this long back straight, made that amazing move. Rossi trying to get a toe. I really don't know if he's got the front-end confidence to get in there really hot against Iannone. And Iannone has now opened the throttle and got away from him. Half a lap to go. We ride with Valentino Rossi. Does close right up on the rear wheel of Andrea Iannone.
Yeah, Rossi went from second to fourth on that last lap. Dovizioso went from fourth to second in the blink of an eye. So Rossi now has a look up the inside of Iannone at turn number seven. He's got the inside line. Rossi, can he make it stick? Cuts it back to the apex. No, Andrea Iannone cuts it right back underneath Valentino Rossi. So Rossi was back on the podium, but back now into fourth place. This is brilliant for Dovizioso.
Yeah, half a lap to go. Andrea Dovizioso in second place. Rossi runs it just a little bit wide. Iannone now closing up on Dovizioso. Márquez is going to win. Who is going to finish second? Who is going to finish off the podium? We are about to find out. First of all, salute the race winner, Marc Márquez. Magnificent victory.
Oh, the Ducatis have gone down together. The Ducatis have crashed out together. What a gift for Valentino Rossi. Now, we don't know who was the instigator in that final crash, but what a disaster for Ducati. Andrea Iannone and Andrea Dovizioso out at the final corner. And that means Dani Pedrosa should be able to come through and take an unlikely third place. Can there be any more drama in Argentina?
Unbelievable. Here is Dani Pedrosa on the podium. The two Ducatis, we don't know who was to blame, took each other out.
Well, through the final sector, through the third split, Nick, it was Dovizioso by 0.3 seconds from Andrea Iannone. Eugene Laverty has crossed the line to finish in fourth place. Hector Barbera fifth, Paul Espargaró sixth. There is poor old Andrea Dovizioso. Must have thought he'd got a second successive second place in the bag. He's trying to push that Ducati over the line. Andrea Iannone, well, he looks pretty dejected and deflated. Here we're going to find out what happened.
Here we go, Iannone up the inside. Oh, yeah. Iannone, I think, to blame, well, don't you? Into the side of his teammate Dovizioso, and they both go down. Wow. I don't think there'll be a team dinner tonight, do you?
And you've actually got Dovizioso. He's now running with his bike. He's trying to push it over the finish line so he can actually still finish.
Right, Michele Pirro's just crossed the line in 12th place. He should actually go across the line in 13th or 14th place.
He's hit it. He's just made it over the line. So he's pushed it over the line.
Has he actually got over? Yes, he has. No, yes, he has. 13th place. Well done. Wow. Dreda Vizioso. Mark Marquez, totally unaware of the drama behind him.
Termaster Rio Hondo's getting a bit of a habit of late drama, isn't it? That was unbelievable. I mean, Andrea Iannone, he'll have a bit of explaining to do in that factory, the Ducati garage tonight, because it's a cardinal sin, isn't it, to wipe out your teammate.
I mean, okay, he wanted to finish in second place, but they're both on the podium, weren't they? Great ride by Marc Márquez, though. Right back at it. Honda are back at it. The championship now is finally poised. The other big news, Jorge Lorenzo crashing out. Valentino Rossi in second place. Eugene Lafferty, the Irish rider, in fourth place on that Aspar Ducati. Flag to flag. Well, we don't want them every week, but boy, do they produce some unbelievable results. Here we go. Incident involving Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone currently under investigation. I really can't believe Andrea Dovizioso had anything to do with that particular incident.
No, without being too critical of Andrea Iannone, you're quite right, Nick, there was a second place there, but that was way, way over ambitious. Skittling out your teammate at the last corner as well. That's not going to go down at all well with Gigi Delina. There's Eugene Lafferty, the top non-factory rider. He can't believe it. He's in fourth place. He's in Parc Fermé with Marc Márquez, Valentino Rossi and Dani Pedrosa. Hats off to that man there, because once they'd swapped bikes, Marc Márquez was just in a race of his own. Blitzed away from Valentino Rossi, who did get in a little bit of a tangle back with Tito about, and then just didn't have the confidence in the bike that he had in the first part. He's just checking,
you're sure,
isn't
he? I'm fourth? No, you're sure you've added it up right? Yeah, you certainly are. That was a magnificent ride. Dani Pedrosa didn't look happy in third place, didn't he? Picking up some points. Not happy at all. But Marc Márquez wins for the second time here in Argentina. Follows up his third place in the opening round in Qatar. And Marc Márquez will be leading that world championship. He is by 41 points, 8 points in front of Valentino Rossi, who's finished in second place.
Great performance by Marc Márquez. His first win since that controversial Australian Grand Prix in Phillip Island last October. And now, actually, Marc Márquez, just checking the record books, that was Marc Márquez's 25th MotoGP victory, so he's now tying with Kevin Schwantz. Appropriate that we'll go to Texas in a few days' time in the all-time winners list. Valentino Rossi, well, we said Christmas had come early for Andrea Dovizioso. Well, it certainly did for Rossi, because that move by Andrea Iannone, which is under investigation, you know, Andrea Iannone has now crashed out of both of the opening two rounds of the championship, and he's nicknamed the Maniac. Without being too harsh, it was a bit of a silly move at the final corner, because he was on the podium.
An amazing move to make. Valentino Rossi, you take what comes your way, don't you? And he took it. Jorge Lorenzo out of the race. He crashed out. So he now finds himself down in fourth place in the championship, and that's a fair old gap beginning to open out. There's 16 points between him and Marc Márquez. We go to Austin, Texas, where Márquez has won for the last 3 years in 7 days' time. Dramatic race for many, many different reasons, flag to flag. I think the biggest drama there was the two Ducatis going down on that penultimate corner.
Yeah, Andrea Iannone, he'll have some explaining to do to Ducati and to race direction probably a little bit later on this evening.
Well, a few people escaped with that one. Dani Pedrosa, I think Stefan Bradl, great result for him. Bradley Smith, who'd not looked at all happy in the race, suddenly finds himself in eighth place. And there's Tito Rabat, distraught after his Grand Prix debut last week, a couple of weeks ago, MotoGP-wise, and finishing in ninth place. So, yeah, but you take what's there. You don't crash, get through your flag to flag, and you pick up the points.
Well, yeah, Dani Pedrosa, he saw Maverick Viñales go down very late and thought, well, OK, that's put me inside the top six.
Scott
and then,
Redding dropping out.
Yeah, and then, of course, the Ducatis taking each other out at the final quarter. And Dani Pedrosa, probably one of the most unlikely podiums of his Grand Prix career.
So what a race. what a podium. And here is Danny Pedrosa. He's now talking to Dylan. A wry smile.
Well, Danny, on the podium after quite an entertaining battle with Scott Rennie. But tell us about that. Tell us about the incident in the first turn. That looked like it maybe cost you the chance to fight for the podium.
Yes, I was. I did a good start, and I was running from the outside, and then somebody, I don't know who, came through, straight through the first turn. So I had to avoid. If I kept my line, sure I would crash. So I went totally out, and then in the back of the group was so difficult because the lines they were doing were quite crazy, and of course I couldn't catch up back to my pace. Quite, I lost a lot of laps there with the group. Unfortunately, anyway, my pace wasn't any good. I'm very disappointed for that because I did a horrible race. But from the first corner to the end, I just tried to get the bike to the line, bring the bike to the line, and I maybe the luckiest day of my racing because everybody was crashing in front, so I could get the podium. But I need to look forward to improve my bike to be faster.
Thank you very much, Danny.
Yeah, I think we saw him when he came into Parc Fermé. He was very unhappy indeed. Yeah, he wants the 16 points, but no.
He hasn't had the pace all weekend.
No,
he
hasn't.
To be fair,
no.
To be running up there.
And of course, you know, he's saying he's running and there's different lines being made. That track was still damp. Ask Maverick Vinales, and you really had to run on the racing line. Valentino Rossi, second place, and a smile. No wonder why.
Well, Valentino, that really was a race of two halves. I think in the first one, a great fight with Mark, but then when you came out, you know, you just didn't quite look the same. Mid-141s, it looked like you were struggling quite a lot on bike number two.
Yes, at the beginning I struggled a bit, but after I take my rhythm and with the first bike I was fast. And I can fight with Marquez, I think. So start the fight, so we start to have fun, but after stop restart, with the second bike I never feel the same. I start bad, and after I continue to go slow. I wasn't able to ride like the first. And at the end, the two Ducatis arrive, and I think that without the touch, I cannot arrive on the podium. So it's great. It's a great result. 20 very important points. I'm so happy because it's the first podium of the season.
Thank you very much, Valet.
Sum that up perfectly. I don't think we need to say a word here. A very fortunate second place, but you take what comes your way, and 20 very important points. He's second in the championship. He is 8 points behind Marc Márquez, the race winner and the leader of the world championship.
Well, Mark, you started this day with a very entertaining fight with Valentino out there on the first run, but was it that made you push so hard on your second when you came out, you were just gone?
Yeah, I already know that on the first race was difficult because it still was wet, the track, and especially, you know, with the first bike I didn't feel good already in the practice, but on the second one I know that that was the key. My first five laps with the new tires, and I pushed my 100%, and yeah, I opened the gap, and then just I keep the distance.
Thank you very much, Mark. Congratulations.
Yeah, big race win for Marc Márquez. He leads the world championship. You'd have said this before we arrived in Qatar, that opening Grand Prix, Honda and Marc Márquez would have probably said, I don't think so. We're probably looking at Jerez and coming into Europe before things change. And we are now going to Austin in a week's time, where he's won for the last 3 years. Well, a dramatic race for good reasons, for bad reasons, for tyre reasons, for flag-to-flag reasons. We've had a bit of everything here. But at the outcome, when we go get on that plane to Austin tomorrow, it's Marc Márquez that leads that world championship by 8 points.
Wonder what was going through Valentino Rossi's mind when he saw those two Ducatis go down at the final corner right in front of him. Thank you very much. 20 precious world championship points for the Italian and his first podium finish of the season. Cool. Such drama. You know, Dovizioso out at the penultimate corner. Jorge Lorenzo crashing out. He just did not have the pace at all in the early part of the race.
So, of course, the clouds have cleared away now, haven't yes. they? It's probably going to be a nice evening here at Termas de Rio Hondo. Been a dramatic day of racing. Not even a glance between Valentino Rossi and Marc Márquez. They walk past each other It was a dramatic race. It wasn't the close race that we probably, I don't say we would have expected, right? Just it's still telling us that the incident involving Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone is still under investigation. Here we go. Make your own minds up. I think we have here. Iannone just slid away and took Dovizioso out, didn't he?
I'm afraid to say that Andrea Iannone, he got in way, way too hot. He lost the front, and that's he just completely skittled out Andrea Dovizioso. Got to feel a bit of sympathy for Andrea Dovizioso because he pounced in one move at turn number five to get by on Valentino Rossi and Andrea Iannone. He did actually manage to push it over the line for 13th place.
You don't see that so often in Grand Prix racing now, do you, riders having to push the bike over the line?
I mean, he's quite lucky that the finish line's so close to the last corner,
right,
isn't it?
Yeah, I'm trying to think. If that would have been Qatar, it would have been a bit difficult, wouldn't it? Having to push it down. That would start and finish straight. So, the other news here, 3 years, a new deal has been signed to come back to the circuit here at Termas de Rio Hondo. So, the new deal has been signed. We've been here for the third time. As always, a dramatic race for good and bad reasons. And this is Paul Espargaro with the onboard camera, running off track as you can see, and getting back on. And Paul Espargaro in the end finishes a really decent sixth place. Well, you don't want to get onto that wet grass, do you?
I was just thinking that.
You really do not want to get onto the grass. He's a lucky boy there, Paul Espargaro. I think he's pretty pleased with that sixth place.
Yeah, wet grass, slick tyres, and 260 odd horsepower. It's not a good combination.
There is Marc Márquez, absolutely delighted. His first Grand Prix victory of the season. First one since Australia last year, Phillip Island, and it all kicked off after that one, didn't it? Wonder if it's all going to kick out. Oh, I don't think there's any real controversy in this one, but he is onto the podium. Marc Márquez wins here in Argentina. Valentino Rossi in second place, and Dani Pedrosa, a rather... Oh, Márquez has gone down on the top step of the podium.
To be fair, that was the first mistake he's made all day.
Valentino Rossi saying, why couldn't you have done that in the race?
Only Marc Márquez could crash on the podium.
That sums up the race. It sums up the weekend. It's been scorching hot weather. There's been dirty tracks. There's been problems with tyres. There's been flag-to-flag races. There's been rain. And that is the result. Marc Márquez wins, Valentino Rossi second, Dani Pedrosa third.
Dani Pedrosa about to collect his 101st MotoGP podium trophy for a lucky third place. Dani admitted the luck was on his side today. Valentino Rossi, his first podium of the season, the 212th out of his World Championship career.
And I'm sure he would agree, secretly the luck was with him as well, wasn't it? That's what the crowd, that's what they wanted to see. No Maradona shirt this time round for the man who's finished second. But that is 20 valuable, valuable points. Second in the World Championship. Just 8 points down on Marc Márquez, who wins the race and will receive his trophy for doing exactly that.
51st Grand Prix win of his career for Marc Márquez. The 25th in his MotoGP career. And after he crashed, getting onto the podium.
All right, Spanish national anthem. Two rounds gone. This is going to be one hell of a championship. We'll be right back. Marc Márquez wins here in Argentina to take the lead in the 2016 MotoGP World Championship by 8 precious points from his bitter, bitter rival Valentino Rossi, who has finished in second place. Dani Pedrosa moves into third place in the championship. So 1-2-3 in the race, 1-2-3 in the championship. But this race contains an awful lot more. The crash of the two Ducatis when they're on the podium coming into the penultimate corner. It's a flag-to-flag race after Michelin were concerned that their riders couldn't go the full race distance and the race was reduced to 20 laps. Absolutely everything happened in this race, but Marc Márquez kept cool, he kept calm, and he looked like a rider on a mission. You can hear what the crowd think. They chant Valentino Rossi's name, but he doesn't lead the World Championship. But he's right in there, 37 years old. He's right in there, just 8 points behind Marc Márquez on that top step. Dani Pedrosa, I think, bemused by it all a little bit. Says it was a bad race for him. He had a bad race. He picked up 16 points, and he finds himself in third place in the championship.